The Saints could have Alvin Kamara back in the lineup for Sunday's game against the Bears at the Dome. Dome's all lit up. Can't wait. Now, Alvin Kamara did tweet yesterday that he will see everyone on Sunday. Joining me now to talk about Sunday's game is Saints Happy Hour podcast host Ralph Marlborough. And I know you were ecstatic when you saw that tweet. And it was just simply see y'all Sunday with a heart emoji.
Listen, Alvin Kamara's back. We can forgive him for his possible transgression. It's going to be all good. He's practicing remotely. We forgive you on your second touchdown Sunday, Alvin. That's what I'll say. Look, Leslie, the Saints are better than the Bears every way. They're better at quarterback. They're better at offensive line. They're better at receiver. They're better on defense. And also, Chicago, they give us lasagna and they tell us it's deep dish pizza. That's annoying and possibly that's a food crime. The Bears, they also foisted Mike Ditka upon us and nearly destroyed the Saints beyond repair.
That's true.
But let's don't overlook the Bears. The Saints are a 10-point favorite. Let's enjoy the Saints, giving them the beating that they deserve. This is going to be the most enjoyable Saints playoff game we've had in about a decade. The Saints are going to boat race the Bears.
That sounds terrible. Okay. What's the game for the Saints against the Bears? I've never heard of that. Boat race.
It's a boat race. You win by a lot.
Okay.
The key for the Saints, it's important that Kamara plays. That's great.
Sure.
But the most important player for this game, I think, that we need to watch injury-wise is Bears linebacker Roquan Smith. If Smith for the Bears can't go, the Bears are put in a nightmare scenario of trying to cover Alvin Kamara and Jared Cook. And remember, last time, the Saints, they didn't have their top three receivers, and Alvin Kamara and Jared Cook ran wild on the Bears. Cook had 5 catches for 51 yards, and that was when the Saints didn't have Michael Thomas, they didn't have Emmanuel Sanders, they didn't have Callaway. So this game, if you're focused on the injury report now that Alvin's going to play, the guy to look at is Roquan Smith. He's a big, huge key for the Bears, and if he can't go, they're in more trouble.
And you keep mentioning last time they played, just for anybody tuning in that doesn't realize, the Saints played the Bears earlier in the season, and we beat them narrowly in overtime. But it's a whole completely different team, and you just mentioned the receiver situation and all that stuff.
It's a different team. Now, the Bears have played better, and they're going to have Mitchell Trubisky at quarterback.
Right.
But remember, in that game, the Saints, they missed a field goal or it wouldn't even have gone to overtime. And the Saints were just a different team then. And the back end of the Saints defense then, it feels like 1,000 years ago, they were a mess on defense. They couldn't cover. The Saints were averaging like 3 defensive pass interference and holding penalties a week. So this is a different Saints defense. I expect pain for the Bears. I expect Sean Payton to coach rings around Matt Nagy. I expect us to remember, Leslie, Michael Thomas, he's only played with Drew Brees 10 quarters. I think America and Saints fans are going to be like, oh yeah, Michael Thomas, remember that guy? He's awesome. So it's going to be the most fun Sunday of the 2020 season. I expect the Saints to beat the Bears so bad, the Bears are going to want to punch Chauncey Gardner-Johnson before halftime.
Well, good, and we hope he's back, too. He also tweeted that I'm back, so we're looking forward to that. The Bears have not beat the Saints since 2008. They've lost six consecutive games to the Saints. That's their longest losing streak. And you mentioned Michael Thomas back and that him and Drew Brees have only played 10 quarters together. Alvin Kamara, Thomas, and Brees haven't played together since Brees was injured in Week 10. And they could possibly all be back. The band's back together, baby.
The band's the band's back together. You know, we're on a mission from God. That's a Blues Brother thing. That's Chicago.
It is.
But listen,
yeah,
it's going to be lucky number 7 for the Saints.
Okay.
Listen, I haven't been this confident about the Saints winning a playoff game since they played Arizona in 2009 and crushed the Cardinals.
Okay, you're making me nervous.
The Saints, you know, that's right. We're Saints fans, right? The more confident we get, the confidence, it confuses us and frightens us because we're not used to it. We're used to bad things happening. But trust me, I'm telling you, this Sunday, the Saints are going to burn Chicago to the ground and salt the ground with their ashes. Don't worry about it. It's going to be a party. It's going to be great.
Awesome.
The 3,000 people are going to be planning to get the tickets for the next week because the Saints will be playing next week.
And you did mention that missed kick. Back in the regular season, of course, it's the Windy City. It's really hard to kick at Soldier Field. Not going to be a problem inside the Dome. Okay, we're out of time, but thank you so much for your expertise. We appreciate you.
All right, Leslie.
Okay, the Saints taking on the Bears Sunday at 3:40 at the Superdome. You can watch that game right here on Channel 4. April?